Molt bona tarda a tothom. It's a pleasure for me to be here again. And I'm going to talk about the challenges for knowledge. Knowledge tells us how the world is and how to interact with it, how to live and prosper, what to do in life and how to do it in order to succeed and to be happy. And it's even at the base of what we have collectively accepted by being successful. Here, you can see a K and an asterisk. Simple, easy. The key is because of knowledge, of course. And the asterisk is because we use asterisks always to clarify the meaning of the concepts. In this case, the concept of knowledge. Let me thank you, my colleagues. Special thanks to Melva and to Gemma, because they always inspire me a lot for bringing this kind of metaphors that always helps in understanding and then to remember presentations. Well, if we want a collective intelligent and a knowledge society, and a knowledge democracy also, we have to rethink the way we handle, we use, we build and understand knowledge. Here is the asterisk. And to continue with the performance of yesterday evening, let's capture again the be knowledgeistic, because this is what we want to be, and it's like a way of being for having a new conception of knowledge. Here again, the definition of knowledgeistic. Well, at GUNi, working with Christina, also working with Rajesh, and with BAT, we developed a concept paper for the report, and we were thinking about the challenges for knowledge. And we find out that we can at least find 6 main challenges. The first one is the ecology of knowledge. We understand that we must move from a monoculture of scientific knowledge to an ecology of knowledge. This means that instead of just considering the only criteria of truth and validity of knowledge that is found in science, to consider other kind of knowledges, and consider that non-existent or that knowledge is incomplete in any way. Well, the ecology of knowledge, or I sometimes say knowledges, to emphasize that there are many, establishes the necessary epistemological dialogue between the different constellations or sources of knowledge, which must be complementary. The second challenge is the integral human knowledge. We are focused always in rational knowledge. Let's move to integral knowledge, integral human knowledge. Knowledge must be considered as an equilibrium, a mixture of different human ways of knowing, from the intuitive, to experiential, emotional, to feelings, to reason also. And the third challenge is, Christina, in his presentation just a few minutes ago, said something about knowledge for intervention. Most of the knowledge that has been produced in the past and also today is descriptive knowledge. knowledge needs not only to be descriptive, but to prioritize its capacity of transformation, taking into account the context of phenomena and acquiring a problem-solving perspective, and also the creation of alternative futures. I would like to say that many times we are focused on just solving problems, but sometimes we must think in creating things and at the same time avoiding risk and problems. So not just solve problems once they have been created. Knowledge has to integrate a scalar variable in all forms, so the scale at local, national, regional, and global scale, and with all its interrelationships between all the scales. And it also must incorporate the time variable in its different forms, in a circular time, in the cyclical time, and other kind of considerations. The fourth challenge is that we need a holistic and a complex, complex knowledge. This assumes that today, still many of the knowledge that is creating is partial and is done, because of the complexity of creating knowledge in a disciplinary way. There are many, many people and many research groups are working, in an interdisciplinary way. So there are many things that are being doing in this way. But the challenge is how we move to a holistic approach, not leaving the disciplinary thing, but to combine everything, and also to integrate complexity. So we have to integrate to all these technological orientations that, for instance, UPC are based on, but integrate also the humanistic points of view and way of knowing. And we must do it in a multi-perspective way and build upon cross-disciplinary basis and with complexity. And complexity implies the limits of knowledge and therefore assuming ignorance, assuming uncertainty, and insecurity also. The social co-creation of knowledge is the fifth challenge. Sometimes many research groups are a bit isolated and they create some research in an isolated basis. When I remember when I did my PhD, I was very isolated. But we must leave this isolation to go and to create with others. The current polycentric production of knowledge must consider the universities, the new centers of expertise also, and all the agents that can and want to be involved in hybrid, horizontal, and cooperative spaces of reflection and action with the purpose of co-creating the needed knowledge in each situation that is required or is needed. This reflective modernization is also a promotion of equity in the spread, use, and creation of knowledge. This view of knowledge moves from privately produced and for private consumption to a commitment to socialization of knowledge for common public good. The current emphasis in knowledge production and consumption is based on the assumption that knowledge is a commodity. In contrast, the knowledge commons view informs the significance of social control over knowledge production and utilization. In such a shift, commitment to knowledge as contributions to common public good may transform the meanings and practices in public spheres. And the last challenge is the dynamic and creative knowledge. we must move from a static use of knowledge to this dynamic and creative knowledge. Today, ICTs, information and communication technologies, the so-called social web, enable us to access and share information and knowledge, and to interact and collaborate with others easily and instantly through communities with the same interest, what at the same time contributes to enhance sociability. This scenario presents a total revolution for knowledge. The chaotic interaction permits bring into contact different ideas and knowledges, what results in multiple combinations of or mutations that favor creativity and innovation. The process of knowledge creation, knowledge management, and validity now are short in time, and their evolution is and will be unpredictable. I must say that universities are already beginning to make some of these shifts. They are undertaking these challenges. A practice of knowledge democracy linked to an intelligent society would be supported by an increase in the varieties of community university engagement that are arising now in thousands of creative and imaginative ways in universities in literally every part of the world. It would build on a vision for a new architecture of knowledge and an activist sense of social responsibility in higher education. As Cristina has said, we are going to amplify these challenges in our report, in one of the papers, in one of the chapters. So I hope you will enjoy it. And let me finish as I started, with the K and the asterisk. I hope that every time you will see or you think about knowledge, you will take into account the asterisk, okay? Don't miss it, and thank you very much.